Do you want to convert your boring presentation into an animated video? Do you wish to add voiceovers to your presentation by converting it into a video? Or you just want to share your presentation as a YouTube video? Then you are watching the right tutorial. Here is a regular PowerPoint presentation. And this is how it looks after converting it into a video.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence. Hard things first. Keep a positive mindset. Visualize the success.
We have added animated characters, illustrations, voiceovers, and a music track. How cool is that? For this, we are going to use a tool called Animaker. Animaker is an award-winning online DIY video making tool that lets you create animation videos. It is so easy to use that even a 10-year-old kid can create an animated video in just a few minutes. Here are the 5 simple steps that we will be following to convert the PPT into a video. Step 1. Uploading the PowerPoint presentation. Go to your browser and visit the website animaker.com. Sign up for a new account and you will be directed to the dashboard. From here, select the create option on the left, followed by selecting the create video and the blank page option. A new project will be created. The interface of the Animaker is so simple. In the center, we have the workspace where you'll be creating the video. On the right hand side is the scene section. Scenes are similar to what you call slides in a presentation. Similar to how multiple slides combine to form a presentation, several scenes combine to form a video. On the bottom is the timeline. Here is where you can control the elements appearing on the video. Within the timeline, we have 2 sections. First is the scene timeline. On the second is the overall timeline. We'll be looking at them in the later part of this video. On the left hand side is the library. It has all the elements like animated characters, illustrations, images, and all the elements required to convert your presentation into an engaging animated video. Let's see how to import the PPT file into the Animaker application. Click on the file menu and further click on the import PPT option and upload the PPT file. You'll be asked to select a transition effect for the slides. As of now, let's select the no effect option. Further, you will be asked to select an animation effect that you want to add to the elements in the video. For this too, I'm selecting the no effects option. Now you get a prompt to select a music track. You can preview a track by keeping the pointer over it. Select a track for the video. Step 2. Creating avatars and adding animations. Let's see how to create animated characters and add them to the video. There are 2 different ways to add animated characters to the presentation. Either you can use any of the characters that are already present in the library, or you can create a custom character from scratch. The library has a variety of characters. You have adult, male and female characters, animal characters, plus size characters and kids characters. You can click on the character to add it to the workspace. The second way to add characters is to create it from scratch. Let's see how to add a character from scratch. Click on the My Characters section and further click on the Create Your Own option. The Character Builder tool will open in a new window. Select a basic character to begin with. Let's start with the hairstyle. Next, I want to edit the character's eyes. Let's select a different eye and change its color. Similarly, we can edit different parts of the character's face like nose, ears, jawline, and so on. As the next step, I want to edit the character's attire. You can find attires of different cultures and multiple professions. You can also choose wearables like hats, glasses, watches, tattoos, and so on. But for this character, I don't want any, so I'm leaving it as it is. Literally, you can create billions of unique characters using all these options. Once all the changes are made, save it using the save option at the top. Now get back to the project and switch between the My Characters section and the character library. Now the library will reload and you can see the newly created custom character. Click on it to add it to the slide. Right now the character is simply standing. Instead, let's make it do some kind of action. With the character selected, you can see a list of options right above the workspace. Select the option named Action. On the left hand side, you can see the list of actions that can be applied to the character. There are more than 700 different actions that can be applied to the character. Let's select an action that matches with the content of the slide. As the next step, I want to change the color of the background. Click anywhere on the workspace. Now you can see the option to change the color of the background. You can even create gradient background by selecting multiple colors. But for this video, I'm gonna stick with one color. Step 3. Customizing the scenes with animations, illustrations, text, etc. Let's preview the scene using the scene preview option present over the timeline. We can see that the duration of the scene is pretty long. To reduce the duration of the scene, use these plus and minus options present on the timeline. Let's reduce the scene's duration to 5 seconds. As the next step, let's control the timing of the elements in the scene. Let's start with the character. Once you select the character, you can see that a bar appears on the timeline. Use it to control the visibility of the character. For example, I want the character to be visible from the first second. For that, I'm dragging the left edge of the bar and keeping it at the first second on the timeline. If I hit the preview option, you can see that the character appears from the first second on the scene. Right now the character appears without any animation effect, so let's apply one. With the character selected, right above the workspace, click on the animation option. Now you can select among the 50 plus animation effects. You can control the duration of the animation effect by dragging this highlighted part in the timeline. Let's see how to edit the text. Once you select the text, on the left hand side, we can see the options to edit it. We can change the font style, size, color, and apply effects to it. Let's change the font style and decrease its size. Similarly, let's edit the other text too. Let's add animation effects. Let's see how we can add some aesthetics to this scene. Open the object section present on the library. Now further, select this gradient shape, rotate it, increase its size and change its color. Right now it is hiding the text. To move it to the background, do a right click and select position and further select move to back option. Let's add an animation effect to this shape. Let's add one more shape to the scene. Instead of going to the library and adding it from scratch, I'm just gonna copy and paste the current shape by pressing Command C and Command V. You can use the Control key if you're using Windows. This time, after doing the right click, I'm selecting the Move to Backward option so that this new shape stays between the text and the previous shape. I think the color of the character's shirt can be changed to match the color of the theme in this scene. To change the color, select the character, further use the Change Color option and change its color. Let's have a preview of this scene. Similarly, I'm going to go to each of the scenes and add a character and edit the text. Now I'm done with building all the scenes of the video. Let's add transition between the scenes. To add transition, click on the option between the scenes. Now you can choose among 50 plus different transition effects. Let's select this effect. Similarly, I'm going to each of the scenes and adding a transition effect. Step 4. Adding voiceovers and editing the music tracks. In case if you want to add voiceover to the video, here's how you can do it. Click on the Add Voiceover option present over the timeline. You will get 3 more options to add voiceover. you can directly record your voice and add voiceover to the scenes. Or you can upload pre-recorded voiceover files if you have any. Or you can use the inbuilt text-to-speech tool and add voiceover to it. If you click on the text-to-speech option, a pop-up will appear. Type the text that you want to add as a voiceover. Now on the right-hand side, select the gender, language, and a specific voice.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence.
Right now the voice sounds a bit robotic, but you can further customize it. You can control the speed, pitch, and volume of the voiceover. You can even add break and breathing effect between words. Let's have a preview.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence.
If you have a paid plan, then you can use the auto enhance option, which will make the voice sound more human-like in a single click.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence.
Select the add to timeline option to add it to the scene. Let's preview the scene.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence.
Right now the music track overpowers the voiceover track. Let's see how to fix that. Do a right click on the track and select the advanced edit option. Now you would be able to add key points to the track. Using these key points, we can increase or decrease the volume of the track between a specific duration. Let's reduce the volume between the duration where we added the voiceover track.
Three practical tips to boost your confidence.
In the same way, let's add voiceover tracks to the remaining scenes and edit the music track as well. That's it, we have successfully created the video. To have a preview of all the scenes together, we have to use the preview option at the top.
3 practical tips to boost your confidence. Hard things first. Keep a positive mindset. Visualize the success. What is your favorite confidence tip?
Step 5. Sharing and downloading the video. You can share this video project with anyone using the share option at the top. Type in the person's email address and hit send. They will receive an invite link to edit this project. This option is very helpful when you are working as a team. To download the video, click on the publish option and further click on the download video option and the download option. Your PPT will be converted into a video in a matter of minutes and will be ready for download. That is how easy it is to convert your boring PPTs into an engaging animated video using Animaker. So what are you waiting for? Go on and give it a try. If you found this video valuable, leave a like and make sure to subscribe to the channel.